Today we're going to talk about how to install an additional servo on the Bigtree Tech Octopus version 1.1. So I do need to explain a couple of things real quick, because in other tutorials I talk about using different ports to set this up. So we're kind of limited on this board because there's only a couple places where we can find 5 volts to run our servo. And so what we need is a ground pin, which is this dark brown one. The one that appears to be red is voltage, and the yellow one right here is signal. So we need to locate something on this board other than our regular servo port over here that we probably will be using for a BL touch. So we're gonna have to look at the actual diagram of this board and figure out where to do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually show you what it looks like for the pinout diagram. So on the pinout diagram, as you can see, there's lots of pins. And as you look around the board, you can see that they're 3.3 volts. What we're actually looking for is 5 volts. So after investigating a little bit, I couldn't find these pins without going to a different diagram that makes it a little bit more confusing. So I went down into here where it says J74, and we have the pins laid out here. So you can see there's 5 volts, then there's a ground, and then there's a pin called PA15. Let me see if I can zoom in on that a little. So what you can see is this is a chip select pin normally, so it might cause an issue with your steppers, but you can always check or find a different selectable pin, such as in your end stops, for your signal pin if that's the case. But in this case, we're just going to use it for this example so that you understand how to do it in the future. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back over to the workbench for a second here, and I'm going to attach these jumpers to set this up. So the first thing that we need to do is actually connect our voltage. Now keep in mind, when I do this example, there may be issues with the actual connections that I may have to correct, but we'll sort that out in a minute. So the first pin that we need is 5 volts, which is right here. Then we're going to do ground, which I believe is just above it. So we're going to line this up and we're going to slide it in. And then the last one, we're going to try and use the chip select and see where that goes. So that's going to be the pin just above that as well, which is the PA15. So now that we have that connected, what we're going to do is actually tie it together with the servo over here. So the signal pin in this case is going to be our orange wire. And then we're gonna connect the orange over on this side, or yellow, depending upon what you're seeing in the video, which is right there. Then we'll take the voltage wire and we'll do the same. So I'll slide this in, allow you to see the wires. And then we'll do our ground, which will be, in this case, the wire that I'm using is actually somewhat gray in color, but it's connecting to the brown wire over here. So now that we've got that sorted out, the next thing that we need to worry about is actually doing it in the firmware. So I'm going to remove the actual SD card, excuse me, and we're going to place it in this SD card reader so we can write to it, and then place this into the computer. Now you may hear a beep. And so what we'll do now is we'll actually go over to VS Code. So inside VS Code, we have our regular environment, but we have the Explorer up here for the Explorer window. So I'm going to show you that in a little bit more detail. So I'm going to click on the Explorer, then open folder. Then I'm going to go to my downloads folder where I've downloaded Marlin 2.0 and extracted it. And I'm going to go in the first Marlin folder, the second Marlin folder, and then select folder. So once that comes up, What we're going to then do is actually wait on setting our default environment, because this is actually an old environment that they use as default. So we're going to go over to the Marlin folder, the source folder, the core folder, and boards.h. Inside here, we're going to search on Octopus, and our version is the actual 1.1 version. So I'm going to highlight that and copy it. Then I'm going to close out of boards.h. I'm going to minimize core. Then we're going to go down to configuration.h and search on motherboard. Right here we have the RAMPS configuration that we're going to paste our configuration over. And then we're going to scroll up here and change the 0 to a negative 1. And now we've got to set up our actual servos. So I'm going to search on num_servo, and that'll bring us to the servo selection down here. So I'm going to remove the comment by hitting the control button and slash, and I'm going to change the actual number of servos to 2, because the other one's used for the BL touch in most cases. And we also have to add a second delay. Now this may have changed, but in previous versions of Marlin, if you don't have the comma and another delay, it will cause a compiler failure. So we'll not worry about that. We'll just do it the old way for the moment, because this is a matrix of delays, I believe. Anyways, let's go back over to source core boards.h. We need to figure out what our chipset is, which is STM32F. So that means that if we want to set up our default environment, we need to go over to the INI folder. We need to find our chipset, which is STMF44. So it's probably in here. So we'll search on Octopus. And there's our board. So I'm going to copy that. Then I'm going to close out of the actual board definition for the moment and go to platformio.ini, highlight the Mega 2560 and paste our configuration. Now there's one more step that we need to address, and that's what servo we're going to use. So I need to go back over to the source folder, the core folder, but not actually the core folder, pardon me. We're gonna go to the pins folder. Now we're going to find our chipset again, which is STM32F4. And we're going to find our board in here, which is the Octopus 1.1. And what it says here is to go to the pins file for the BigTree Tech Octopus version 1 common, because that's where our pins will be stored. So we're going to click on that one as soon as we find it, which is right here. And we're going to search on servo. Once you find the servo, what you're going to do, because this one's already defined, we're going to copy this line. Then we're going to paste one right below it, and we're going to change the index from 0 to 1 because it's our second servo. Now we do need to correct this still, because this pin cannot be shared between the two, obviously, because it's a different signal pin. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go over to the browser for a second, and we're gonna pull that up, and we're gonna see what the pin number was, which is PA15, I believe. So we'll go back over to VS Code, and inside VS Code, what we'll do is we'll actually do PA15. Now we can verify the other one by going back over to the desktop for a second. And inside of the browser, we can see up here that it says PB6 and then PB7 for BL Touch. So if we look at VS Code, it's using PB6. So PA15 15 is what we can use. So now that we have that set up, what we're going to do is set up the actual compile. So to compile this, what we're going to need to do is first do a clean. And the reason that I say that in this case is because up here inside .pio, the default configuration is already present. So we can just clean that out with the little garbage can. Next, what we're going to have to do is click on the checkbox over here, and this will compile for us. Now, if we run into an issue where it fails, try a second compile, because sometimes things build out of order. If you have a third failure with a actual compiler build, that's when you want to find the very first thing that failed in the list here and correct that issue. So this is going to finish up in just a second, but we can actually watch what's going on inside here. So you can see that it's building as it goes along the files that it needs to finish. And then it ends on firmware.bin. At this point, what we want to do is we want to right click on this and say reveal in file explorer. Now this will be what we need to put over here, because this was the previous load of firmware.bin. It gets renamed in all capital letters to .cur with firmware. Now, cur is not cursor in this case. It's still a firmware binary file. I just want to remind you of that. It's just their way of noting that it's changed. So we're going to go send to the E drive. And here's our new firmware to load. So what we're going to do is go back over to the workbench for a moment. We're going to pull out the actual drive that we used. We're going to place this drive back in here. And then we're going to power it. And in this case, the jumper is set to USB power. So it's going to allow the firmware to load. Keep in mind that if you do use certain steppers, you will have to possibly remove the actual jumper power and run off direct power. So now that that's loaded, what we're going to do is go over to Pronerface and see if we can actually test this out. So the interesting thing about Pronerface is I'll leave a link in it. It's a great way to troubleshoot possible issues. So here we have Pronerface, and the first issue we're going to run into is that it says COM port 1. So we need to determine what our COM port is. So in this case, what we're going to have to do is figure it out this way. So we're going to go over to the desktop and type device, and that'll bring up Device Manager. And inside Device Manager, we're going to see ports. Now the first COM port on this desktop computer is default always. So the next one's COM port 9. And that would be the COM port that we're going to need to use to connect. So I'm going to change the 1 to a 9, and then I'm going to press connect. Now you can see the printer is now online. So what we're going to do next is actually see what's going on with the servo. So the command for it is actually M280. Then we're going to say P, and this is going to be our index. So it's the first servo, not the 01. So it's actually the second servo, because we count from 0 on up in our index. Next, we're going to do S, and the angle in this case we'll do 45 degrees, and we'll press enter and see what happens. So it moved 45 degrees. Now, if we want to move it back to 0, we can change the 45 to 0 and press enter. So that's the actual 0 position. So let's try 45 again real quick. Let's try doing it as negative 45. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.